Welcome. We're here today to dive into the world of medium voltage switchgear. Specifically, we'll look at three main types: metal-clad, metal-enclosed, and metal-enclosed gas-insulated switchgear, or MEGIS. In this video, we'll explore each type's design, application, and features, as well as key industry standards to help you pick the right equipment for safe and effective operation. But first, what exactly is medium voltage switchgear? Medium voltage switchgear is a centralized collection of circuit breakers, fuses, and switches enclosed in a metal structure used to protect, control, and isolate electrical equipment. Medium voltage switchgear is applied in systems operating between 1 kV and 38 kV, which is typical of large facilities such as data centers, hospitals and institutions, power generation and distribution, and industrial facilities. Each type has specific benefits, especially when it comes to safety, maintenance, and space savings. It is important to consider a variety of specification items and associated costs when determining which switchgear solution is the best fit for your application. Things to consider are voltage class, continuous current, short circuit withstand, arc resistant requirements, and if this is an indoor or outdoor installation. Standards for electrical switchgear are defined by IEEE in North America and by IEC in Europe and other parts of the world. The IEEE C37.20 family of standards are what is referenced for medium voltage switchgear. These standards are essential to ensure equipment meets strict construction, testing, and safety guidelines. In North America, we also have third-party certification groups such as Underwriters Laboratory, UL, and the Canadian Standards Association, CSA. These nationally recognized testing labs, NRTLs, provide production and design testing standards in line with and beyond what the IEEE standards call for, and audit manufacturers for increased testing accountability. In addition to these standards, you also need to be aware of any regional codes or utility requirements, such as in California, Chicago, or New York City, who may have their own design requirements for their lineups. You may be asking yourself, why do we have all these different types of switchgear standards and requirements? The answer is, switchgear standards exist to drive safety. They create fundamental requirements around the construction, ratings, and testing process to ensure you're getting a solution that will operate safely and reliably in your application and create uniformity across manufacturers to help maintenance and field personnel to understand and operate equipment. Now that we've covered standards, let's discuss the three primary types of medium voltage switchgear.
Let's talk about metal enclosed switchgear, which is dictated by IEEE C37.20.3. This type of equipment is typically used for a visual means of disconnect, and in most cases is a primary protection for a power transformer. This standard is less stringent than other medium voltage designs, which allows for configurations to meet any need, including front access or constricted footprint applications. Inside, the structure is open. Barriers and compartmentalization are not required, as they would be in other designs. And there's no requirement for isolation for different voltages within the structure. Switching and protective devices are typically fixed mounted, and bare bus is the standard, but insulation and plating options are available. Switching devices are typical knife blade switches that can act as a visible means of disconnect. They are limited in their number of operations and can be load break rated, but provide no overload or fault protection without adding a fuse or circuit breaker. There are two types of overcurrent and fault protection available in metal enclosed products: power fuses that can be current limiting or non-current limiting, or circuit breakers with either a trip unit like our VCPT breaker or with a protective relay, typical of most medium voltage gear. There are pros and cons to consider when choosing between using a power fuse or circuit breaker in your metal enclosed equipment. Let's review some of the items you need to consider. With power fuses, you will have lower initial cost and they are maintenance free by design. You will also have a quicker response time and higher interrupting ratings as a standard, which allows for easy coordination and higher fault protection of downstream equipment. However, power fuses only provide single phase protection, so if a fault occurs, it can lead to single phase events. And motors that see single phasing can overheat and may be damaged over time. Also, when events occur, Fuses are designed to blow, which means they must be replaced, leading to potential cost in maintenance and downtime. With circuit breakers, you have different benefits. Circuit breakers are designed to be resettable if an overload event occurs. They also can have more modes of protection, including ground fault and arc flash protection, through electronic trip units or protective relays. Trip units and protective relays also allow for highly customizable protection settings, allowing for more adjustable coordination with downstream equipment. A circuit breaker provides three-phase protection and will trip all three phases if an event occurs. They can also provide increased visibility and control through communications. However, with a circuit breaker, you're going to have higher initial cost and maintenance requirements due to mechanical complexity. As your interrupting rating requirements increase, circuit breakers may not be able to achieve desired ratings or may be cost prohibitive. In summary, the benefits of metal enclosed switchgear include lower cost, ease of access for maintenance as compartments are more open, and flexible design due to less strict design standards. Metal enclosed switchgear is ideal for applications with lower fault current ratings, cost or footprint constraints, and when lower switching operations are needed.
Metal-clad switchgear is the most common design of switchgear used for the distribution of electricity throughout a facility. Driven by the IEEE C37.20.2 standard, metal-clad switchgear is a heavily compartmentalized design that includes multiple features to enhance operator safety. Each component, such as circuit breakers, instrument transformers, cables, and bus bars, are housed in individual grounded metal compartments. The standard requires that no live parts are accessible. This includes features such as automatic shutters on removable drawout compartments, which offers safety benefits by isolating live parts to help prevent accidental contact by an operator. Low voltage or secondary control devices and associated wiring are also isolated from the medium voltage or primary circuits by grounded metal barriers, but can be mounted on doors in front of the circuit breaker or other devices. The IEEE C37.20.2 standard requires that the switching and interrupting device must be a removable type with a mechanism between connected and disconnected position, and equipped with self-aligning, self-coupling, primary and secondary connections. In metal-clad switchgear, a vacuum circuit breaker is used as this interrupting device. In a vacuum circuit breaker, the arc interruption takes place inside of sealed vacuum bottles. The contacts inside the vacuum allow the arc to be extinguished quickly, reducing the arc energy in a very compact space. The breaker requires a protective relay to act as the brains or trip unit for this device. The relay will take inputs from current and voltage transformers installed in the equipment to interrupt fault conditions and monitor the equipment's performance. Breakers and auxiliary devices, such as voltage transformers, must be mounted on a removable drawout mechanism, which allows for easier maintenance and a visual means of disconnect. For a complete insulation system, the medium voltage bus is coated with epoxy insulation throughout. Bolted joints and connections are covered by removable silicone insulating boots. Lug connections also need to be insulated. Those can be field taped or cable boots can be purchased from the manufacturer. Mechanical interlocks are required for proper operating sequence. As an example, an interlock is integrated in the racking screw housing to prevent racking of the circuit breaker while closed. Metal-clad is known for its robust construction, but also provides application-specific benefits, such as automatic transfer schemes and increased control, since electrically operated breakers are used as a standard. In summary, the benefits of metal-clad switchgear designs include enhanced safety through fully insulated bus bars, isolation shutters, and compartmentalization, high reliability with superior fault isolation and with mechanical interlocks that prevent unintended operation, and a robust design allowing for a variety of configurations. Metal-clad switchgear is ideal for applications where an extra level of protection and reliability are required.
Compact switchgear, also known as metal-enclosed gas-insulated switchgear, or MEGIS, is designed to reduce the footprint of a lineup, especially at the 27 and 38 kV classes. These configurations are built to the IEEE C37.20.9 standard. The construction of MEGIS equipment is a vacuum interrupter or breaker in a sealed pressurized tank. The overcurrent protection is provided by a vacuum interrupter in conjunction with a protective relay, similar to metal-clad switchgear. The gas medium in the tanks acts as an insulator due to its high dielectric strength, allowing for a reduced footprint as compared to air-insulated switchgear. With the main power components installed in a hermetically sealed tanks, there is no maintenance required and a reduced likelihood of arc faults, preventing downtime of the equipment. The tank is designed as a sealed pressure system with a maximum leakage rate of 0.1% per year by the standard. With the design, it is ideal for high altitude installations, as derating is not required as it would be for air insulated applications. The MEGIS standard enables increased BIL options for higher voltage classes. For example, the MEGIS standard for 38 kV provides the option to have a 200 kV BIL system, where metal-clad switchgear standard is only 150 kV BIL. This will allow you to connect to a utility with 200 kV BIL requirements. Unlike metal-clad switchgear, which utilize draw-out breakers to isolate the circuit, MEGIS uses a three-position switch to connect or disconnect the breaker from the main bus. The final position in the three-position switch allows you to ground the connected line or load cables through the closed circuit breaker. To safely access the cable compartment, interlocking is required with the main breaker to prevent an operator from entering the cable compartment while the breaker is in the closed position. In summary, the benefits of compact switchgear or MEGIS include higher system uptime with no maintenance requirements, reduced footprint due to the compact design, making it suitable for application with space constraints, and a safe alternative for isolation and grounding using the three-position switch. Compact switchgear is ideal for space-limited applications, especially in higher voltage classes, and provides excellent performance in harsh environments. Now that we've covered the three categories of medium voltage switchgear, let's discuss specialty applications. An important safety feature for medium voltage switchgear is the arc-resistant design option. Conventional electrical switchgear built to IEEE standard provides a relatively safe environment for equipment and maintenance personnel during normal operating conditions. However, conventional switchgear is not designed to withstand the enormous energy released during an electrical fault condition. Switchgear certified as arc-resistant is designed to safely contain and redirect arc flash energy away from the operator. This is typically accomplished by diverting arc flash energy through a plenum to an area it can be released without danger of harm to personnel or equipment. In addition to various IEEE design standards for medium voltage switchgear, arc-resistant gear must comply to the testing requirements designed by IEEE C37.20.7. The most common arc-resistant design is Type 2B. Type 2B must keep the operator safe on any side of the equipment during an arc event with the low voltage compartment door open.
In recent years, digital advancements are also helping transform switchgear to significantly reduce downtime, lower maintenance costs, and get operators away from the equipment. By incorporating relays, voltage and current sensing, and communication capabilities, you collect vast data on power quality, equipment performance, and event history, as well as provide control functionality from safely outside the arc flash boundary. This data can be sent to a central monitoring system for real-time analysis, optimizing efficiency and predictive maintenance. Examples of technology helping optimize switchgear operations include 1. Arc flash relays. These devices use light sensors to detect an arc flash to open a breaker faster, reducing the duration and impact of the event. 2. Thermal monitoring. Continuous thermal sensors check lug connections and monitor potential hotspots, providing real-time trend data on system performance. The system provides maintenance alerts, allowing the operator to be proactive instead of reactive. This can eliminate the cost and maintenance associated with periodic IR scans. 3. Remote racking. This feature can be used to perform operations such as disconnect, test, and connect of circuit breakers and auxiliary compartments of switchgear to increase operator safety by keeping them outside of the arc flash boundary. 4. Partial discharge monitoring. This solution helps detect corona due to insulation degradation, allowing operators to address issues before they become catastrophic.
From flexible metal enclosed designs to robust metal-clad solutions to highly compact MEGIS options, we hope this video helped you better understand medium voltage switchgear. But always remember when installing switchgear, careful planning is crucial. Considerations for transportation, site dimensions, and environmental hazards will go a long way to ensure a long, safe, and reliable equipment lifespan. To learn more about how to correctly specify and install medium voltage switchgear, please visit us at eaton.com/mvswitchgear. To see medium voltage equipment in action, contact us or your local Eaton representative to schedule a visit to one of Eaton's Power System Experience Centers today.